It's an office photo collection any wheeler dealer would envy.
That's a very, very unique piece.
The court asked Benny Fisher to auction it off.
This was where he was a guest at the inauguration of the president.
This person is very tied in politically. Can you imagine going into his office and seeing all of this? I mean, that adds a lot of credibility to who this person is.
Absolutely, absolutely.
There's the one with President George Bush, his brother Jeb, and a bunch of other governors. Palin, Schwarzenegger, Richardson. Scott Rothstein is the man standing with all these politicians. He's a fixture in Fort Lauderdale. An attorney who donated at least $1.9 million to political campaigns. Okay. One of Florida Governor Charlie Crist's biggest financial backers.
This is, of course, a birthday for the governor.
He bought the governor's birthday cake, and it was $1,000 a candle, and he bought 52 candles for Governor Crist. Here you have the biggest criminal ever to basically grace the state, who is literally blowing out the governor's birthday candles. You look at that, and it's a pretty heavy story.
These same politicians, forever caught on film, arm in arm, with a convicted felon. Now, these are up for auction to pay off his victims. Because it turns out, Rothstein, seen here at a distance being led away in handcuffs, ran the largest Ponzi scheme in South Florida history. The FBI says his investors are out $1.2 billion. That's exactly why, in November, the FBI and IRS started confiscating his prized possessions.
Now the mansions, the Ferraris, the yachts, the law firm, and his friends are all gone.
And this is how it happened. Rothstein ran one of the most powerful law firms in Florida. He told his wealthy friends he had a business proposition for them.
He said he had clients who did not want to wait for their settlement payouts. If his investor friends cut him a check, that money would go straight to his clients. In exchange for the money, those clients would take a smaller settlement. The investors would get all the rest of the money, along with about a 20-plus return on their money. It sounded like a good deal. The trouble is, none of those clients ever existed.
Right.
Bob Norman covered this scheme as a reporter for the Broward County New Times.
Did you have to understand, Rothstein's law firm had hired ex-judges, prosecutors, big-name attorneys. He would bring them in again to enhance his own credibility.
According to the lawsuit, Rothstein was using the money he made from fake lawsuit settlements to cozy up to politicians and help them fund their campaigns. But he was also spending his millions on himself and on his toilet seats.
This is the golden toilet.
Norman showed us pictures someone sent him of Rothstein's his and hers gold toilet seats worth an estimated $25,000 apiece.
If someone told me yesterday, as a matter of fact, they said that I was lulled into believing this myth that he created, and I really believed that he had a golden touch. And what better way to kind of perpetuate that myth than to have a golden toilet?
Rothstein's fictitious settlement scheme collapsed this October. When he ran out of enough money to pay back investors, Rothstein wired himself $16 million and boarded a private jet bound for Morocco. When he returned, he gave an exclusive interview to CNN affiliate WSVN.
I went away for the purpose of making sure that I had my head on straight, that when I came back, I had already been through all the emotional things, had been through the hysterics, had been through all the other things that you go through when you realize that you have done something that you shouldn't have done.
It was an apparent act of contrition. He promised to pay everyone back.
I will not stop until every single penny is paid back.
An attorney for some of his victims says he doesn't buy it.
He's a pathological liar. He's trying to avoid life in prison. He doesn't want to be a Bernie Madoff.
It's like Madoff on crack. It's just he did it a whole lot faster and a whole lot wilder.